Today, I'm going to show you some of my favorite containers to grow in using the Kratky hydroponic method. There's a multitude of containers that you can choose. I've made some mistakes along the way. Like I say, this is my first year doing this, and I'm going to show you exactly where I failed and where I've succeeded. So hello and welcome to the Garden of Feodora, where I'm not an expert, I'm your friend. So let's get to it. Now, whether you like Sunny D or not, it doesn't matter. Or if you choose the purple stuff, just get yourself a container and fill it with some hydroponic fluid. This right here is the Master Blend formula. I'm going to show you how to mix this down in a different video. And fill it up. Right here I have a 1-inch net pot. With, I think that's a Jimmy Nardello pepper that I'm placing in. Got some rocks to sturdy it, and it's looking good. This will sit in here for about 3 weeks until I upgrade it. It can actually go its whole life in there. This right here is another pepper. Look at this, growing in a 3-gallon container. It's an ice cream container that I got from Walmart. And it also has basil. And look, it's grown out of the same cup. As long as the roots are getting their nutrients and getting fed, it's not really going to complain too much, you know? And this is really the set it and forget it method. And over here, look at this. This is a bishop pepper. This is growing in an even smaller container. That's a 2-inch net pot that I have in here. I just, you know, cut open the top. It's a larger pepper in a smaller container. This is just to prove that as long as the roots are getting the nutrients it needs and getting the oxygen balance that it needs as well, it'll survive. And this is normally when I upgrade into these containers here. This is a Jimmy Nardello pepper, and it's growing in this container here. This container is actually two for a dollar at the dollar store. And then I have this here growing in some sort of orange juice container. And this is a smaller tomato. This is a it's a bonsai growing in here. You see when I spray paint the sides, I leave a little viewing window so I can see the roots and see how it's doing and how far up on nutrients it needs to go. And you see here, this is an eggplant growing in a 5-gallon container. It's starting to flower. It's looking good. And over here are some more peppers. These are growing in, I believe I think this is a 3-gallon container as well. And it's doing well. I gotta top it off, obviously. But it's looking very, very good. It's healthy, it's bright green. Check it out. These are my okra. I have 2 okra growing in a 5-gallon container. And these leaves are huge. Look at that. And the thing about this is, since I put them in there, I have not topped off this liquid. Look at that red okra. And this one is the green one. Later on in the video, I'm going to show you how they've grown in about 2 days after this. And these are some peppers. These are some cayennes I have growing. I have 3 of those in a 5-gallon bucket. I have 2 peppers in this bucket right here. And here we are on the back porch. This right here is my Warakawa tomato. And it is definitely in need of some nutrients. So let me go ahead and show you how I top this off. While I'm doing that, let me tell you something real quick. I've been asked, do I check my pH? I do not. I'm on a well system. I don't need to check my pH. Well, I don't check my pH when I mix down my master blend and other things like that. I just simply get the water, I mix it. I don't really do too much thinking about it. I just kind of do it, you know? I let the science do the science and me do the thing.
So as you see here, I have an apple juice container, some other kind of container, and a milk jug. This is how it looks in the milk jug right now because it definitely needs some liquid. I'm going to actually put this in the ground because I don't have a 5-gallon bucket. These right here, same thing. They're going to go in the ground. These are large indeterminate tomatoes, and I think it's best for indeterminate tomatoes to go in a 5-gallon bucket, or if you have determinate tomatoes or dwarf tomatoes, 3-gallon buckets, I think that's fine. If you're able to keep up on the water and the nutrients, you actually can do this. You just would have to feed it every 2 days. Because like a baby, once they start growing, they're going to start eating. So I'm going to get these down, and then I'm going to show you some other ones on what I think is acceptable for, different growing size containers for your vegetables. And real quick, this is the old German that came out of that there, out of the apple juice container. And look at those roots. So we're going to go ahead and get this beautiful, beautiful gal right into the soil here.
All right, now we back inside. And as I said, I have these little containers here I got from the dollar store. You see that moss, well, that algae in there? It doesn't really bother me too much. And from what I understand and from what I've seen, it doesn't really hurt. It doesn't hurt the plant. Not my plants anyway. Some of these I do spray paint because I like the colors. And I do think maybe it can be better. So I'm not telling you what to do here. I'm just saying that I like to spray paint them. Because I'm an artist and I like to spray paint stuff, even the jar. But I've had lots of success with a lot of algae. I don't check my pH and things are looking good. Check it out.
Look at all this kale. Look at all this kale I just harvested from this one container right here. This is about 3 gallons and I have 3 different kale plants going. That one right there, I think it's about time we replace. And then I have this up here at the top. I have Swiss chard here. I have more kale. And check this out. I'm getting ready to harvest some of this dino kale. This is actually my favorite. Look how big those leaves are. And I have more of it growing in the house. And here I have black magic kale. More kale here and here. A lot of Swiss chard growing here. I'm getting ready to take it in the house and cook it down. After I get some more, the lady's in there cooking tonight. I told her I'd take care of the veggies. All right, real quick. I know the video is over, but I want to show you something. This is just a few days later. And look at that. The okra has came in. Look at that. The okra has came in. And the red okra is coming in as well. That's all. I mean it now. Peace.
And as always, thank you for rocking with the best. And don't forget, peace and blessings from the Garden of Feodora.